Okay. Hey guys, welcome to the second Rhino tutorial. And in this tutorial, we'll be looking at how to create a simple Rhino house with the roof, the walls, the frame, the window frames, door frames, and the foundation floor itself. So to pop it all off first, we'll start with talking about how we're going to set up our Rhino files. So make sure you go to your files, properties, units, and for this project you can do whatever unit you want, but we'll be going in millimeters. And for the grids, we'll have it 100, 10, and 10. Minor grid lines every 10, major grid lines every 10 as well. And press OK with that. And make sure at the bottom tabs you have grid snap, planar, O snap, smart track, and gumball all on. As for the O snap, which is this tab right here, as it's going, on and off, we want to have end, midpoint, and intersection point on for this project. They'll help you create more accurate and direct projects so that there aren't many units that are like 1.0013 millimeters, for example, something like that. So we'll start with a simple box. For this project, I'll create a 10 by 100 by 100 by 100 box. What that means is the width is 100, the length will also be 100, and the height will be 100. And simply, oh yeah, before we do that, also make sure you guys have created your layers. For this project, we'll have the roof, the wall, window, door, and floor. To do that, you can simply double click on the layer, and you'll be able to choose the name of it. And for the sake of clarity of this, for doing Rhino, make sure you have all your materials on different colors if you can. So for example, I'm just going to make this example layer into, if you click on this square, you'll be able to choose your different colors, as you can see. You can play around with the hues, you can play around, with everything you want. Go all out, have fun with it. Doesn't really matter how you do it. Yeah, just have fun. Just going to delete this layer for now. Don't need it. Okay. We'll start off by clicking on the cube and typing explode. You can see, and we press enter. What that will do, I'm sure some of you guys may have learned this. What that will do is create all the surfaces into separate pieces. Now that I can click on these, yeah. And what I'll first do is create the floor layer, the floor component, I guess, for this house. To do that, we'll double click on the floor layer, and we'll also change this bottom surface into the layer of the floor. To do that, we simply right click on the layer of the floor. I'll come up with these tabs, and you click Change Object Layer. And now the bottom surface of the box is now for the floor layer. What we'll do for this project is just simply type in Extrude Surface, type Enter, and then it will say Select Surfaces to Extrude. We'll click on the floor surface and press Enter. And now we can choose which direction the extrusion will go. We'll make it go down, and we can also choose the extrusion distance, as you can see in the top left. And all we have to do is, well, for this project, let's do 10. Make sure to also have your solid options on as yes, so that we can create a solid box instead of having an extruded surface. Type in enter, so select your direction. Press enter, and we'll now have this floor slash foundation created for you. Next, we'll work on the wall. Similar to the floor, we'll just be creating a thick wall. For this, let's just turn off our roof so that we can see the ins. Oh, for this, we should also change the layers as it's on the roof layer right now. So what we want to do is right to left, select all the walls, press right click on the wall, layer, and then change object layer. Just to see the inside of the walls, let's turn off our roof visibility by clicking on the light bulbs on the right side on the layers, like this. And what we'll do is use a command called offset surface. So what offset surface does is it will quite literally offset any surfaces that you have chosen. So let's go right to left again and select all the surfaces that we need to thicken as a wall. And we press enter. And as you can see, in this case, all the arrows are directed outwards. That means the surfaces will offset outwards. Since we want to create the walls inwards, we'll click a command called flip all right here, as you can see. Type that. If you click that, all the walls will go inwards now. And let's make our thickness of the wall about 5. So if it's not 5 right now, then you can click the distance, type in 5, and press enter again. And it should create these walls for you, like this. All right, that's done. Let's move on to the roof. As for the roof, it's a little trickier because we need to make a triangle polyline first and then create our roof. So as you can see, I'll explain the planar now and what it does. So if you click your planar off, you go to polyline and create a simple triangle. Doesn't really matter how big, doesn't really matter how tall you want it to be. If you create a triangle like this, it will move one of the points to the surfaces of your, I guess, main plane, right? And most of the times, you don't want your line to do that. So what we want to do is if you click the planar, if you have it enabled, it will make all, at least it will make most of your lines in most circumstances in the same planar as the surface that you have selected your points on. So in this case, my planar is this surface, and all my points will be on that same planar. It's a little confusing, but once you do it a couple times, you'll understand what it means. So if I do the same thing again, this time it should be on the same planar as this surface here, as you can see, like this. Oh yeah, also make sure you have selected your roof layer. And what we'll do now is simply type in planar surface. What planar surface does is it will create a surface on any closed curve that you have. And we'll go back to our perspective view. And we'll type in extrude surface. Extrude surface. And it says to select surfaces to extrude, we'll click the triangle that we just created for our roof, press enter, and again, we'll be able to choose a direction. And for this case, let's just click on the edge of the other side of the roof, which is this wall right here, like this. Now that we've created our simple triangle, we want to create a simple offhang of the roof. To do that, what I like to do is type in a command called extract surface. You press enter, it'll tell you to select the surface to extract. What it will do is it'll quite literally extract any surfaces that is, even if it's a 3D, even if it's a connected poly surface. And we want to have our copy on in this case. If you do it as no, it will create a gap in the surface like this. But in this case, we want to have it as yes. Type enter, click the roof that you want to extract and enter. And what it does is it has created a copy of that surface that we just selected. From this, we want to create an extrusion. And you can do it two ways. You can either use the extrude surface command again, or You can use this gumball tool, which is these colorful little lines that you see here. You can use these gumball tools to extrude it as well. So as you can see, there are these little dots on these line on the arrows, and what they do is they do the same principle as extruding a surface or a curve. So what I'll do is click the dot, and let's make the thickness of the roof about 5. I'll simply create a roof like this, extrude like that. Yep. And then now it's a little tricky. What we want to do is hold Control and Shift and click on the edge of this surface right here, which we want to extrude later on for the offhang. And as you can see, it will only select this surface. If you do Control and Shift, I mean Control and left click, it won't work. If you do Shift and left click, it won't work. All you want to do is Control Shift and left click, and we'll select the surface as you see here. And now what I want to do is go back to our right view and type in the command extrude surface again. As you can see, it's going perpendicular to the surface that we selected, and we don't want to do that. So we'll click the direction button so that we can choose the direction in which the extrusion will happen. So since we wanted to go in the same angle as the roof, we'll first click the top of the roof, then down all the way to the bottom of the roof over here. And if you do that, it should create a straight extrusion that goes in the same direction as the roof, as shown here. Since we want the extrusion, let's make the extrusion distance about 10. So just type 10 and press enter. And now we have created one side of the offhang roof. And what we want to do now is type in a command called mirror. What that does is it will quite literally mirror any object that you have selected. So select the one side of the roof, press enter after you type mirror, and then create the plane for the mirror. So basically, what you're doing in this case is just creating a mirror for the object to reflect off of. So if I were to click here and go towards the right, it will create a mirror upwards. But then in this case, we want to create a mirror going straight upwards like this. So after you do that, just click left click, and it should have created a simple offhang roof like this. Now moving on, we'll create the doors. So left click the door layer, and then we can do this in any view you want, but for the sake of simplicity, I'll be doing it in the right view. All we'll do is simply just make sure you click on one of the surfaces here. On the same planar as the surface through your mid and your O snap points, like this, as you can see. It should come up with these white opacity lines, low opacity lines that you hang off of. So what I want to do is just click, in this case, I'm going to click on the midpoint. And then let's make it around 30 width and 60 height. As you can see, I'll make this a bit darker actually, it's a little too hard to see. There we go. As you can see, it's created a simple rectangle. And what I want to do with this, since we're creating the door frame for now, is to type offset. And since door frames aren't that big, let's make the distance about 2. So again, if it's not 2, or really whatever distance you want, but if it's not 2, just type and click distance and type 2. And then as you can see, it will select either the inwards or the outwards of the offset. So really choose whatever you want. But in this case, I'm just going to put it inwards because it's a bit easier to clean up later on. So I'll do that. Now what we want to do, since door frames don't have a frame at the bottom of the door, we want to remove these areas here. Basically this line here. To do that, I'm going to simply create a line that goes straight downwards from this corner to all the way down. It should automatically select those segments with the O snap that you have turned on. So again, I'll do here, down all the way to here at the intersection points. Now what I want to do is type in a command called trim. And it'll say to select a cutting object. And in this case, the cutting object that we will have are the two little lines that we just created, which is this one and this one. So after you selected those two, press enter. And now what we select from here will be deleted from the intersection of the curve that we just selected. So as you can see, it says select object to trim, right? And then make sure you hold shift when you do this, is click this line here and this line down here. Now, just to show you what happened, if you press enter again, just to show you what happened, I'll be putting it outside because it's not that easy to see, is that now the bottom lines at the frames are gone now. And what we'll do now, since these are still disconnected from the curve, the main curve of the frame, what I'll do now is select all of it and type in join. And now what it does is it joins the whole entire curves as shown, like this. So I'm going to do it for the main frame again. Type in join. Oh yeah, also, if you hold Alt, it will ignore any object that you select when you do the left click holds like this. As you can see, if I don't press hold, it will select the surface here, which is kind of awkward. So if you hold Alt and then go left to right like this over the door frame, it will select the door frames like this and type join, and it will have created your first door frame. Now what I want to do is make the door ways, I guess. So you can do this again in your right or your perspective, but for this one, I'm just going to do my perspective shot. What I'll do is planar surface. Again, it'll create any surface inside a closed curve. And what I'll do from the surface that I just created from the curve is I will do extrude surface. And you can either extrude it all the way towards this corner, which is the thickness of the wall, or you can type in yourself the extrusion distance, which is 5, because the thickness of the wall is 5 itself. So if you just type in 5, it'll have created this door frame, as you can see. And what we want to do now is to type in a command called boolean difference. I'm sure some of you guys may have probably used it a couple times in your media classes, maybe. But what we'll do now is it says to select the surfaces or poly surfaces to subtract from. Since we want to subtract from the wall, we'll click the wall, press enter. Make sure you have your delete input off in this case. And then click the door frame. Press enter again. And it will have created a doorway. It will have split your door, I mean your walls, into two parts like this. And just delete this one because you won't really be needing it, as so. Actually, what you could do with this, I lied, is you can maybe make a door out of it by simply just clicking on this square on your gumball and just extruding it downwards with your grid snap off, like this. And now you have your simple doorway right here. Make sure you have it into your surface like this. And yeah, nice. Now we'll just be creating our window. Go into your window layers. And simply, we'll be doing the exact same process as the door, just without the bottom frame cut off. So it should be very easy. Just click anywhere of the surface. Make sure you have it on the same plane again. So just click one of the corners, the ends, wherever you want. I'm just going to be making this my planar so that the surface doesn't go behind. As you can see, if I were to select a rectangle, let's say like here, right, it'll actually create the rectangle all the way behind into this main axes planar area. So what I like to do is to create my windows that have the same, create my windows on the same surface. So what I'll do is just select any point really, and then make a rectangle. I'll make it about 30 by 20. I'll just move this around to wherever I want. I'll make sure I have grid set back on as well. What about that? As so, like this. And again, like last time, type offset, click your curve, put it inwards, and then this time, instead of trimming, we will do select both of the curves that we just offsetted and type in planar surface. It'll automatically create a surface in between those curves, like this, as you can see. And now what we'll do is go back to perspective shot. And then, again, like last time, we'll select the, we'll type in Boolean difference, select the wall. Actually, wait, oh wait, my bad. We'll do extrude surface. Select the surface that we want to extrude, type enter, and then for this one, I'll just demonstrate on how to create a extrusion without the distance command. So I'm just going to, for example, click here, right? And it should automatically go into the same width as the wall. So after you've done that, type the, click the poly surface, and you'll see that the frame has been created. What we want to do now is Boolean difference. Select the subtract from, which is the wall, and then subtract width, which is the frame. Type enter, and it will have created this cut piece again, like this. And just move this into your window layer, and just, you know, extrude it downwards again. Oh, sorry. Put your grid snap off, extrude it downwards again, like so, to have whatever thickness you want. I'll do like this for now. And now you'll have created your windows and your doors. That'll be the end of the tutorial, but I recommend you try to make your own sort of windows and doors on, you know, whichever side of the house you want. I think it'd be a great practice to do, you know, for your future projects. All right. Thank you, guys.